Hi, my name is Daniel Gallardo. I just recorded a drum cover to By Your Side by Rod Wave. But before I show you that, let's get into the gear I used in this video. For this cover, I'm using the drum kit I normally do, but with some modifications. So I took off the rack tom and instead decided just to have my floor tom. I put a big fat snare drum mute on it to make sure that it's tight and responsive. I'm trying to emulate 808 sounds here, so that works for that. As far as my snare goes, I'm using the same snare I used in my last cover, which is the 14-inch Mapex Steel Blade snare, but I taped an 8-inch splash on top of it to make it much more crisp and dry. It sounds much more like an 808 trap snare rather than an acoustic snare. As far as cymbals go, on my left, I have 14-inch Meinl Pure Alloy hats. I have a 10-inch Meinl Trash Splash. Now, as you can see, this one is very wrecked. It's broken, it's got tape on it, but I find that sometimes with these type of stacker cymbals and these splash cymbals, the more crack they get, the more character it adds to the sound sometimes. So on my right, I have a 20-inch Byzance Meinl Extra Dry Thin Crash. This one is my go-to when it comes to a nice, washy, open crash. When it comes to hardware, I'm using DW hardware aside from my Iron Cobra hi-hat pedal, which has served me well over the years. Overall, with this kit setup, I was going for tight, aggressive sounds, and I think that translated in the cover. I guess you'll have to listen and let me know what you think in the comments below. So I'm approaching a trap sound in this cover, and in order to achieve that, I approach it with fundamentals, i.e. rudiments. A lot of the stuff that I'm playing over the kit is a lot of linear grooves, and a lot of it is achieved by simple adjustments and hand pressure, especially when it comes to doing really fast trills on the hi-hat, really fast diddles on the snare. All of that is very much so in the nuance and the minutia of pressure of the hands, fulcrum in the way that you're holding the stick, as well as what these back fingers are doing when it comes to catching the rebound of the stick and making that rebound how you want it to. So that's how I achieved those trills, those really fast, essentially twitch muscle movements. In addition to this, I implemented a lot of use when it comes to the cross stick technique. Normally, this isn't really heard in high energy playing. Generally, in an acoustic set, you kind of think of a cross stick more so in a bossa nova context or maybe some sort of Latin or jazz, but given the way that music is made now, a lot of producers are making beats from sample packs and they're pulling random rims and clicks and different things out of the folders in their computers. So I find that using cross stick in these high energy beats actually works pretty well. A little more than halfway through the song, this guy decided to run away from me. I could have stopped, but I decided not to, and I think it is somewhat of an important learning lesson to just try to keep going with a performance, even if things go wrong. If the energy feels right, you should just keep going. I think it turned out well. Let me know what you think.
I'm on my feelings.